Hi everyone, welcome back to MadGebs. Today I'm going to be doing another reaction to yet another Nightwish song. This one is specifically recommended by Michael or Mad Dog over from my Patreon page. If you guys don't know already, I do have a Patreon page where as you become members at different levels, your recommendations on there take priority over the ones I see on the comments here on YouTube. I'm still going to react to the suggestions you guys put on in the comments themselves, but for the members specifically, I am going to be paying more close attention to those recommendations. So Mike recommended Shudder Before the Beautiful, which he mentioned goes hand in hand with Yours is an Empty Hope. It's usually played back to back. Again, I'm not familiar with the discography or what order these songs are in, so I'm just going off of the recommendations you guys give me. So he mentioned that he listens to those two, like they complement each other very well. So I'm curious to see what this one sounds like. Every time I am about to watch a Nightwish video, I get chills. It's hot in November and August right now for some reason, but I'm getting chills. So I'm gonna put on my noise canceling headphones once again because they did a great job last time till I get some, I guess, much better headphones. Hopefully my camera stays in focus. All right, if you do wanna check out the Patreon page and the perks and such, I will link it up above in case you're thinking of checking it out. Again, any support I get, even on people just watching and commenting is amazing enough. But sometimes YouTube doesn't give you as much help to create more content. So over on that channel, I'm hoping to do a lot more than just react. So that's my goal. And I'm open to suggestions as well as to what you want to see. All right, let's get into the reaction. Gonna take like a couple breaths. It's like I'm freaking about to give birth. Okay, it's nothing like that. To all the mothers out there who've given birth, nothing like that at all. Okay. All right, let me not go crazy with the volume because I don't want to shatter my ears and not be able to hear music anymore in the future. So let's keep it at where it is right now.
The deepest solace lies in understanding. This ancient unseen stream, a shudder before the beautiful.
I like the drums. And I like everything else. Musicians are so talented. I know the musicians came before the lead singers like Flora. I've learned that by now, but they amaze me every time. Right there. I love their duos.
Mm-hmm.
As if they didn't have variety in their instruments, they have this weird thing that they're doing with their keyboard. That thing looks like Groot. Chubby Groot. Can't get over how tall she is. It's commanding. Chills. The camera shaking.
The music of the song, deep silence between the notes, deafens me with endless love. In the sacred island earth, a pilgrim shining bright.
Oh, that flute came out of nowhere. Or is it a flute? I don't know. Trumpets? Did I just hear trumpets? It's a long note. Whoa. Wow. So, somehow this manages to give me the chills for some reason. It's like, it sounds like an anthem. And I will say, the more I listen to Nightwish, and the more I get to kind of get used to, I mean, you can never get used to Floor, it seems like, but the more I get familiar with her, I can kind of now shift my focus to the rest of the band. It takes a while to get there, I feel like, especially if you're a new listener, because you're just so enamored with Floor. But I do like his voice, the guy that does the duo with her. I'm sorry, I don't know their names. I'm going to look up. I know the others were more consistent than the lead singers who have kept switching, but the guy with the two separate beards. Okay, Marco, why isn't he listed on Wikipedia? Marco Tapani, I love his voice. I kind of want to hear if he's been in his own band. I want to hear his vocals in isolation. To just go beyond Nightwish for once, right? But to go beyond Floor when it comes to Nightwish. But I do want to look up the lyrics. I liked it. It's not as heavy as what I tend to like or what I like, but I mean, that doesn't matter, right? If you have to have an ear for the variety. And I am not just a metalhead, I guess I could call myself that. I feel weird calling myself that. But there's a lot more to music, of course. So we have to be able to open our ears and listen to everything because there's beauty in everything, right? So I love the metal elements. You hear the tempo of the metal. The metal tempo, the drums and the bass and the guitar, right? But then you have the keyboard and the voices of Flora and Marco combined just amplify it and bring it to a different level. Or they make it what is symphonic metal and not just standard metal, if that makes sense. So I think that's pretty unique. I've never seen any other band do this. I have to look back at your comments and see if there's any other bands that you've recommended that are similar to this. I know I've asked this question before, is are there any other bands that are like this? I've never seen any, so I'm open to suggestions. But yeah, that's my thought. I went on forever. But as I mentioned, the more deeper analysis of things outside of just reactions, I'll probably start to just post on the Patreon page. I think a lot more people that are on YouTube are looking to just watch the reactions. That's kind of what I'm noticing when I look at the comments and the YouTube analytics. So let me know if that's the case. If you, as we head towards me posting more of the analysis and lyric reviews and album reviews and things that aren't reactions on the Patreon page, as we move towards that, you're probably likely to not see the extended versions of these videos on YouTube. You're probably just going to get the reaction and that'll be it. Again, thank you guys for watching. Comment below with your suggestions and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.